Hi everyone, Mike here from Tesla. PRTG SLA Reporter is an extension designed to streamline the service level agreement monitoring process. With PRTG SLA Reporter, you can easily track your SLAs and ensure optimal performance at the same time as monitoring SLA data based on values directly from PRTG Network Monitor, giving you better visibility on whether you're meeting the needs of your customers. It also offers granular reporting on downtime, including user root cause analysis, and a flexible GUI so you can customize your preferred SLA monitoring intervals to suit your needs. Let's have a look at how to install and configure it for your PRTG instance. So let's get started with the installation. We're going to run the installer. Now, the wizard will automatically verify if all the necessary prerequisites are installed, such as .NET framework and SQL Server. Those are required. If any of those are missing, the wizard will give you options to download and install them. But here we've got them already, so let's click Next. If you plan to use an existing SQL Server set up from another machine, for instance, simply select the SQL Server Express option, which you'll see, and specify the details during the installation process, including the credentials. But right now, let's accept the license agreement. Click Next. We've got our settings there already, and we can click Install. So we're all done. Once you launch SLA Reporter, for the first time, this is what you're going to see. This is the dashboard. This gives you an overview of all of your SLAs. So now the SLA Reporter is installed, we can move on to the configuration and setup. So the first thing that SLA Reporter will ask you when it launches is it will want to create a user profile and add connections to PRTG. I've already set this up already, so I can now show you how to modify that if you need to make any changes, but it also applies to the first time setup. So, first of all, it's going to ask us to create a user. So we can do that by clicking the Add button and fill in the following information. And click Submit. And that now creates our user to access the application. Next, you'll need to define a connection to PRTG. So first, you want to make sure that SLA can report to your PRTG web server. And then you'll want to click Add in the PRTG service section. And then we want to add our PRTG connection details. Okay, so now we've got our PRTG core server set up in SLA Reporter. Next, SLA Reporter will want you to define an SMTP mail address. So this step enables SLA Reporter to automatically send the monthly reports via email to a designated distribution list. So we can find that in the mailing profile section. You can see I've already got my details set up. You'll want to fill this out for your own configuration, obviously. So after completing the setup process, you'll be greeted on the first time of launching with the dashboard. So you'll log in using your previously created username and immediately access the dashboard interface. Up here on the left-hand corner, we can see how many license days you've got remaining for your license. We can see last month SLAs and break it down into sensors as well. But mainly here, we can see our SLAs that we have set up. In graph format, quite useful feature here is we can click on the breaches themselves and that will take us to that specific report for that breach. So you can find out exactly what was breached and find out why you're there. So in order to set up your first SLA, the first thing you're going to need to do is use the filters menu. That's on the left-hand side here. And we're going to create a filter. Now, a filter is basically what sorts the sensors from PRTG, what type of sensors you want to create an SLA report on. So let's add a new filter. Now, I'd like to filter my ping sensors. So you can filter via tag or name, but I'm going to use tag. So all of our PRTG sensors with the ping sensor tag, they're going to be shown here on the left-hand side in our device tree. Now here we can select the objects that we want to include into our SLA report. Now I'm interested in remote probe monitoring, so I'm going to select that object in the device tree. And that's now going to highlight all of the ping sensors available there. I'm going to click Submit. I'm going to give it an alias. That's basically a name for the filter. So I'm going to call it Ping Remote Probes. Let's click Yes. And on the right-hand side now, we can see that that's created the sensors there. If we do want to get rid of that for whatever reason, you can select that little tick box and press Delete. But I'm going to leave it there for the time being. One important thing to keep in mind is if you do add new sensors in PRTG on that object in the future, using that tag, so if you were to add more ping sensors with the ping sensor tag, that will be automatically added to the filter. So you don't need to go back and manually add those, which is a really, really nice feature. So we have our filter set up. We're going to set up our first SLA with it. So let's click on the SLA option. We're going to click on Add. And let's fill out the details for our new SLA. We're going to call it New Company. And it's going to have a start date. Let's go for the start of the year. So we want an uptime pretty high. We have high expectations. We're going to expect a monthly breach of maybe 1, yearly breach of 12. Let's click Next. Then we're going to set a timetable. So we'd like this to run Monday to Friday. We don't want to include the detail over the weekend. Default is set to full day, but you can obviously customize the time period if that's needed. Then it's going to ask us to attach an alias for the filter now. It's the filter we set up earlier, which is our ping remote probes. So it's going to apply our SLA to the ping remote probes filter. Click Submit, and there we go. That's now created our SLA settings, and that will now begin checking on those sensors as we need it to. Next, let's have a look at the Schedules tab. So this enables us to obviously set up a scheduling period for when we'd like the SLA to run. Add a new one just by clicking Add top left, as always. We're going to give it a start date, start of the month, end of the month. Let's give it some start times. So next we can look at the planned downtimes. So obviously you're going to have potentially maintenance periods on your devices where those sensors aren't going to be available. So potentially you won't want those included in your SLA report, as that would then lead to a breach. So what you can do here in the planned downtime sensor section is to add those planned downtime periods. So let's click the Add button as usual. Let's give it the details. We've got a Patch Friday schedule set up here, so let's go for that. So during our Patch Friday, between 3 o'clock and 5 o'clock in the afternoon, we're not going to be including that in the SLA. So specifically, I'd like to check on these devices because I know they're included in Patch Friday. We're going to select our remote probe SLA that we created. We're going to select our ping remote probes filter that we've already set up. You can add other things like ticket numbers and comments there if you need. Click submit, and that's now going to create our planned downtime, which will take effect in the SLA. So it's not going to give us any false information. Next, we want to look at reports. This is obviously really important because your customers will want to know if there were breaches, why there were breaches, and you can give them all that information just by going to the reports here. The reports are generated automatically. The first time you create an SLA, though, there may be no reports here because the reporter might not have run yet. It runs once an hour, but if you need it to run manually, sync it manually, you can just click on the play button in the top right-hand corner next to the login, and it will ask if you want to start PRG polling. You just say yes, and it will then start that report creation process manually. Okay, and then finally, we want to look at scheduled reports. So from this page, you can generate reports for custom intervals and send them to specific email addresses that you need to. So create a new one, as always, by clicking Add. Let's give it a name. We're going to choose our Patch Friday schedule. We're going to choose our remote probes agreement. Let's use the current period and monthly. Yeah, let's go for last day of every month. So that's now created our scheduled report, which will happen at the end of every month. So once your reports have been generated, you're probably going to want to access those and send them to your customers or wherever they need to go. And you can do that by going to the reports tab. And then clicking on the export button. And what that's going to do, it's going to generate a PDF report out of SLA Reporter. It will then be downloaded. You can access that and send it out as you need to. And there you have it. With the SLA Reporter extension for PRTG Network Monitor, managing your service level agreements has never been easier. From setting up new SLAs to generating comprehensive reports, SLA Reporter streamlines the process, giving you better visibility and control. If you like the video, don't forget to give us a like and subscribe below.